Hello, dear friends. Welcome to Shiksha Mantra. And as you can see, what is written in the blackboard, this, that, these, those, yes, dear friends, just look, just have a look at them. So why I have written these, that, these, those, even before we start our discussion? It's very simple, because these words, if you consider them grammatically, sometimes or most of the times, for most of the students or most of the people, they come to be very much confusion. Confusion for what? Because whenever we discuss of these words grammatically, they provides us option. What option? They can either be pronoun, and at the same time they can be adjectives. Yes, dear friends, if you learn adjectives or pronoun, what you will get? You will see that they comes both as demonstrative pronouns and demonstrative adjectives. So today, my point is, I'm going to share with you a very simple trick. A very simple fact with which you can easily understand whether they are used as pronouns or as adjectives. Yes, dear friends, English grammar is nothing but a game of tips and tricks. Here you have to find out the secrets of these grammar tips, and very easily you can answer, you can find out everything regarding these demonstratives. So, by not wasting much time, let's begin our discussion with a fresh blogging in Shiksha Mantra. So, let's begin. Yes, dear friends, before we start our actual discussion, it's better for us to find out the basics of adjectives and basics of pronouns. Yes, dear friends, it's better for us to discuss the basics of pronouns first. What do we consider as pronoun? It's very simple. A pronoun is what? It's a replacement. Replacement for what? It's a replacement for a noun. Yes, dear friends, there you have to remember it, that the pronouns are the replacements for nouns. So they replace the nouns, and they come obviously in those positions. This is a question, you have to learn it, you have to remember it. Why, where does a pronoun occurs? A pronoun occurs only on these positions of a sentence where a noun may occur. The whole game is about position. It's a game of positions. If you consider football match, there you have several positions, and obviously in those positions, some specialists of those positions are being kept. Obviously, we won't put a defender into the goal as goalkeeper. Neither we put a goalkeeper as a forward. So what we have to do? We have to place the proper skillful people in proper position to show their skills. So what happens with our sentences as well? Here, when we consider pronouns, they can occur only in the positions a noun may occur. Now, on the other hand, if we consider adjectives, now where the adjectives occur, we have to find out the pronouns or the adjectives. Na? So where the adjectives occur, they occur just before a noun. We have two different types of adjectives, as you know. One is attributive adjective and the other is predicative adjective. We aren't going to that predicative part now. Rather, we are discussing on attributive adjectives. So, they occur where? They occur before a noun. This is a very, very simple consideration. They occur before nouns. Now the game is regarding nouns. Whether it's replacing a noun or it occurs before a noun. So there lies the consideration, and there we come to the decision whether this is a pronoun or an adjective. Now what's the relation they share with this, that, these, those, or whatever we have written there? Yes, dear friends, now if we consider these things, this or that or these or those, you have to remember that these are, I never call them either demonstrative pronouns or demonstrative adjectives. I always call them only demonstrative. Yes, dear friends, I only call them demonstrative. Now you may ask me, so why don't you add adjectives or pronouns with them? Because just believe me, the identity of these words, these parts of speeches are not adjectives or pronouns until they're used in sentences. So far, they aren't used in a sentence, they are considered only as demonstrative. Now, how they become adjective or pronoun? Let me produce a sentence here. If I say, this is a chalk. If I say this is a chalk, or there's another sentence I'm producing here, this chalk is yellow. So here I have used this in the same way, but obviously there comes some difference. If you consider the first, this, it's demonstrative. I'm saying this is a chalk. I'm saying this is a chalk, or this chalk is yellow. So I'm saying this. So it's demonstrative, but it's demonstrative which is accepting a verb. So it's used as the subject of a verb. Look. Here this, the first sentence we are considering now. So here this is used as what? As the subject of a verb. So it's accepting the verb. It's suggesting the state. So obviously here the subject means it's a noun. So here this is used as a noun. That means it occurs in the position of a noun. So it's very simple here. This, it's obviously a demonstrative pronoun. After this comes the verb. This is used as a subject of the verb. That means it's used as a noun. It occurs in the position of a noun. That means it's a pronoun. But the whole game changes as you consider the second sentence. Let me change the color a bit so it will be easier for you to find out, to understand. In the second sentence, the whole thing gets changed. Here, we are using this chalk. Now consider this. Consider this, this. Yes, dear friends, just consider this, this. Here, I have used two this. Okay, so whatever it may be. This comes before chalk. Now chalk is a noun. Chalk is a noun. So this is used here as an adjective. Yes, dear friends, because this plus chalk, adjective plus noun, and it comes as a phrase, this chalk, which accepts the verb and it becomes the subject of the verb. So as it is conjugated with a noun, it becomes demonstrative adjectives. Yes, dear friends, this is the very simple consideration. Just you have to think over it. Let us wipe out the board and begin the conclusion of this discussion. Just find out the essence year that we have found in this discussion. But before this, let's wipe the board. So here we have a clean board again to write down. Yes, dear friends. So finally, what we got? Finally, we have got when we want to find out demonstrative and we have to consider whether they are pronoun or they are adjectives. For pronouns, we will find them used singularly with a verb, or whenever they are pronouns, they will occur in the position of nouns, where the nouns may occur in the sentence. So you'll find them in the positions of nouns. There's no confusion. It will be easier for you if I say that is a ball. Take very simple sentences, so it would be easier for us to understand. So that is a ball. Verb, it's used as the subject of this verb. That means it is used as a noun. So there's no confusion that this is a demonstrative pronoun. But the same thing, the whole game changes. As you consider it as an adjective, what speciality you will find? You'll find that it's coming before a noun. So there we will get demonstrative plus noun, this conjugation. So you will get the same sentence as that ball is mine. So the game changes here. Why? Because here you have a noun and before the noun comes the demonstrative. So you have noun, before the noun comes the demonstrative, and you will get it as demonstrative adjectives. Yes, dear friends, this is the very simple trick. If you apply them, if you follow whether there's something after the demonstrative or not. If there's a noun after the demonstrative, it's an adjective. If there's nothing after the demonstrative, it's a pronoun. That's simple it is. And I think after, actually, if you observe this video totally, you would never get confused regarding demonstrative. But what's about the others? What's about the interrogative adjectives? They're also the same confusion, interrogative adjectives or interrogative pronouns. You mustn't get confused there as well. Just apply the same theory everywhere, because you'll find so very different kinds or different types of adjectives and pronouns, and so very different words which may be used both as adjective and as pronouns, you get confused. So there's nothing to get confused. Just consider if they are conjugated with a noun or they're directly used as a noun. If they are conjugated with a noun to form a phrase, obviously they are adjectives. And if they are used directly without any conjugation of a noun, rather they are used as a noun, they are pronouns. That's it. With this simple trick, you can win everything. And if you stay with Shiksha Mantra, Shiksha Mantra will honestly try to supply you several tips and tricks like this for English grammar, so that your grammar learning won't be easy, but it would be fun. Yes, dear friends, that's all from today. We are returning very soon. Until then, bye bye. Happy learning.